and welcome to another episode of Tribunal of the Grid, where we talk about all things Power Rangers, including the actors that play them. My name is Brandon.
I am Lena.
And I'm Will.
And today, we will be mainly covering our own Power Month, because, you know, Hasbro got a little, they get a little slack in my opinion. I mean, I'm just saying. I thought that they was going to be bringing the heat. You know what I'm saying? I thought it was going to be releasing, you know, shit left and right. I was like, okay, Power Month. Y'all hyping this junk up like it's going to be like gravy on biscuits. But no, it was a little dry this week. It was a little dry. It was like having a Popeye's biscuit with no honey. And you just sitting there gagging to death because you ain't got nothing to drink. Like, that's what this week was given. But, you know, other than that, we're going to be talking about the Power Month for us, the episodes that you guys picked. And also, we're just going to just go ahead and cover some comments that people left on the page, and also talk about the very minute thing that happened with Power Month this week, according to Hasbro. But first, I start, Go right ahead.
I was very curious. This is a follow-up from last week. Do you remember we're talking about the Ninja Turtles and the release of the Ninja Turtles and all the great little outfits that they got going on? And then I learned, or so did most of us did, that there's a fifth turtle. So, of course, my little self got really interested and wanted to know how Janika?
I believe so.
Came.
Yeah, Janika.
You better be sitting down for this, okay?
Okay.
She was once a human.
I'm sorry, what?
Okay.
She was once a human named Janika, or known as Jenny. So, essentially, long story short, somehow Splinter became, I guess, the master of the Foot Clan. And she was one of their foot soldiers. And from what I understood, at some point, her and Casey got together. I don't know what happened to April, but obviously they broke up. But this girl here is a trained assassin. She has served jail and she has served jail time and all that niche, right?
Okay.
So I guess during one of the situation of a battle, she got severely injured. And in order to save her life, they came up with the blood transfusion. So Leonardo transfused his blood into her, therefore healing her and transforming her because you know how their blood has mutation in it. So can you imagine going in thinking you're a whole ass human and then you wake up and you find out you're a whole ass turtle? That's what happened to you. And then get this, it gets even creepier. This is the part where I'm like, kind of like, I can't believe this shit just happened. Her and Casey are still together now that she's a turtle. And I'm all like, what is this, bestiality now?
Well, I mean, technically, it's not, mainly because she was a human. It is weird.
Yeah.
But she was a human.
So yeah, that's my latest update on Janika. That's how a fifth turtle came to be. Wow. That's also why she looks like a dude versus a girl, like Venus.
Interesting.
I think they wanted to go for a more, like an actual turtle.
Yeah, but so I've been looking, again, I searched a lot. There, depending on the artist that illustrates her, there are some scenes where she is a tomboy. Even as a human, she was more of a tomboy. So it makes sense. It's like, whatever, right? I don't understand why her name sounds so, you know, black, if you will.
Ethnic?
Ethnic. Yeah, okay, ethnic.
We'll go. Let's not do that. Just go with black.
Like, okay, good. Thank you. Thank you. I was like, do I really have to be politically correct with you guys? Like, come on.
It's black. Like, no.
But she's a whole black girl.
You tell me one black, one white Janika. Like, let's not do this.
Right? Thank you. Thank you, Brandon. Yeah, so she's blonde and white. She's a whole blonde and white person. So I don't know
how
she got her name because, yeah.
No, Let me not do this.
That's why I was curious, because I'm like, okay, how the frick did this fifth turtle come to be, and how do we not know about it? You know? So she is introduced in the comics, and she does have her own spinoff to kind of explain her backstory.
Oh, wow.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know that.
See, you learn something new. So she's a whole, she's a whole turtle. Like, yeah, a whole turtle now. And they're really trying to make money off her, I guess, in that regards. Because, you know, obviously they're selling her origin story. She's obviously with the turtles now. But I'm not entirely sure if the Foot Clan is a good, if they're good people or they're bad, because, you know, they've always been bad when they were under Shredder. So I'm kind of confused here. But again, obviously that's a whole new topic for another day. But that's my latest update on Janiqua, because I was very curious. So I did my research, and I'm still shook to this day that she is a human that turned into a turtle because she got injured. And that's how they saved her.
Wow. Well, I mean,
thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Right. Well, no, like, because you know what? And I'm glad you did that, because it's one of those situations where it's like, I'm sure somebody would have been, you know, like looking or was listening, was like, who is this Janiqua person? Let me go research. And probably just didn't have time to. And then you went ahead and did it. And now they're listening. And they're like, you know what? Thank you. And they might actually even go and read the comic for themselves. So and
that's exactly where I'm at. After I read the Power Rangers, obviously, so that we can have our lovely discussions on it, I'm going to go ahead and do the comics for her, because I'm very curious. Like, like, she's a badass. She's a trained assassin. She served jail time. Like, what? She's a whole badass, you know? So yeah.
All right. Well, all right, badass. White Janiqua.
right?
I guarantee you her name was Jenny, and she went to jail, and she got hit with some people, and they was like, all right, let's go ahead and call you Janiqua, because you down, you about that life.
That's what I'm thinking. Oh, yeah, before we move on, what I wanted to bring up, I think I lost my train of thought there, was depending on who illustrates her, some photos, she does look more girly, and they do cover her chest. And obviously her bottoms. And in some, she just wears pants. So, and she looks more masculine. So I think it depends on who illustrates her. She does look more girly in some, and then more masculine in some. Either or, it's cool, you know. Gender fluid, we're all about that. Yeah.
All right. All right, well, okay, Miss Janiqua, we're going to go ahead and mosey on over, and then maybe we might see her pop up in the Power Rangers comics, because you know they may. You never know. So hey, from Miss Janiqua and the Turtles, I'm pretty sure y'all already know, but I gotta keep pimping it out, because I don't care. I'm gonna keep telling y'all. We are on we are on Google Podcasts, we are on Apple Podcasts, and we are on SoundCloud and YouTube. So wherever you are listening, please continue on commenting, giving us the thumbs ups. Like, we really appreciate it, and it helps us. So thank you. Speaking of, we have a comment from our boy Derek Hervey, who had went ahead and commented and said, hey y'all, thank you for the phenomenal feedback. Y'all the real MVPs. Real talk, been on the grind since I came cheesing out my mom's womb. That's cute. Truly, thank y'all so much for the words of encouragement. It means the universe to me. Love the show once more, and honestly can't wait to get a hold of one of those Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle 2-packs when I come across one down the road ahead. I'm all in when it comes to those auditions next year. I'm gonna kick some junk in the trunks. Okay, I hear that.
Right.
And get hella hype like no other in delivering my way towards victory in 2022. Woo, yeah.
Booyah.
That's right.
All right. And oh, one more thing. Love you, tribe. Blessings, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.
That,
sir.
I question you guys, okay? I truly am wondering this now. Thank you so much, Derek. I just want to say that's such a cute comment. But I want to ask you guys, should we have our own, like, I guess, title? Kind of like, you know how people, like, call their fandom like a name? I don't know, like
No.
We're not even like big enough.
No.
Well, I mean, I'm not even gonna say we're not big enough. Like, I just
not big enough.
To me, I just kind of and this is no shade to anybody who does this. Like, I just want to make this perfectly clear. This is no shade, but to me, I just kind of feel like that's to say, oh, someone is a fan of something. And this is the way I look at it. If someone is a fan of you, I'm like, wonderful, great. For me to actually call your fans something is almost kind of, oh, what's the word? Narcissistic, in my opinion. And I'm pretty sure by no means it's not narcissism on their side, for the most part, because you know there are some narcissists in these streets. But I feel like it's a little narcissistic to call someone like to name like your fans like, oh, a special name. Because to me, it's just like, for me personally, I just feel like the respect of just people being like, yo, I really appreciate your work and stuff. It's like, to me, like, I mean, if they want to call themselves a fan club of us, I would welcome it 100%. But for us to do it, it just kind of seemed like, it almost kind of feel grandiose, you know? You know, because like, and the one that comes to mind, obviously, Beyonce, because I mean, I love Beyonce. But
wait, what is Beyonce's fandom name?
The Beehive. The
Beehive.
Oh, girl. Oh, she's Canadian. She doesn't know.
Oh.
But no, like seriously, it is the Beehive. Yeah, because like it's short for bee, like her nickname is bee, right, so and right. Then they add like the hive, so you know. Mm-hmm. So it's the beehive, B-E-Y hive.
It be bothering me when people say bay hive.
Yeah, it's not bay hive. Like, please don't. Someone say bay hive, I'm probably gonna punch you in the throat. Like, don't do that. Like, please don't do that. We all know it's bee, like, because her name is Beyonce, it's not Beyonce.
Well, like, okay, when I say that, I don't actually mean like have our name, but like, hey, welcome back, crew, or like, you know, like a genetic, like yeah, like a genetic phrase.
I mean, yeah, listen, I know what you're, I know where you're coming from with it.
Okay.
I'm just saying this is how I feel about it.
Okay, no, you know,
it's just like, I'd rather, because like that's what happened with Beyonce. Beyonce never came and was like, oh, you guys are gonna be my beehive. Like that never happened. Like it just kind of generically just happened on its own.
Right.
And people were just like, oh, we're the hive or whatever, or what, okay. You know, like that kind of thing. So, okay. You know, if that happens, then so be it. I don't mind it, but right. Yeah, that's just how I feel about it.
Well, you guys comment in our section below. Let us know what you want.
Right. Because if you guys want to do it, then hell, I'll welcome it. Like, yes. And I'll even respond to it with you guys. Right.
Like, no, I'm yes, being serious, right? Because like, I thought about it for a while. And I see especially Derek, he's all like tri crew or whatever. And I love it. But so that's what got me thinking, right? Because I'm like, if we're the tri crew, which is great, because that's who we are. But then how do we in turn respond to everyone else? You know?
Right. No, I feel you. I feel you. No, and I agree. Like, I mean, it's cool. Like I said, if they want to do it, then cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I welcome
it.
But just for us, I'm like, nah.
No, that's fair. I just thought I'd throw that in there, right? So
come on. It's cool. I'm glad you did. I'm glad you did. But no, like, yeah. But it's cool. Like, hey, like I said, y'all, if y'all want to do it out here in these streets, if y'all want to do it, then go right ahead. Mm-hmm. We'll love it. We'll love it, I promise. But yeah, so once again though, Derek, thank you. Like, it means the absolute world to us. Like, I mean, as you can probably hear for yourself, we're literally discussing this. So that literally means that we really do appreciate you. We really do appreciate you for doing this. Like, I mean, we really appreciate the feedback, we appreciate you commenting. We appreciate everything. Like, you have no fucking idea how much we appreciate it. Like, seriously. So keep doing it. We'll keep on bringing you all the commentary because, I mean, we just, we do it, mainly we do it because we love it, but we also do it for you guys. Mm-hmm. Just keeping it 100. Like, we do it because we love it and we love the support that we get from you all. So, you know, that's the driving force behind it. We just love you guys. So, thank you. So, yeah, I have no segue for that. I kind of left myself closed off. But we're going to go ahead and move to Power Month. Damn, I'm weak on these segues today. Okay, so Power Month this week. Ugh. So, before the show, right... Will was trying to hold space for Hasbro. I ain't holding no space for them. I'm not holding space. Now, Will, tell the people what you think. Tell the people what you say.
Oh, I was just saying, you know, this week definitely was lackluster, but, you know, perhaps they'll give us something better next week and the week after.
And you know what I said? That's some bull. That's some bull.
You know what? Something that we mentioned before, but they made like an official post about it. The Flipheads, mm-hmm. the rest of the team has been released. Trini's been released or will be released. Yeah, I guess they're showing up now. In stores?
Yeah, I believe they are showing up in stores. I have to double check, but I believe they are.
Yeah, there's my Trini. She has a bob again, just like the original figure.
Of course.
The Ranger Slayer.
Green with Ranger. The lesbian haircut.
Yeah. Green Ranger Tommy and White Ranger Tommy. White Ranger Tommy looks like he has a ponytail, and Green Ranger Tommy has the mullet.
And then also... What did they do? They turned around and they slapped us in the face with a re-release of the Gold Ranger, Mighty Morphin Red Ranger, and Lord Dragon. But, you want to know what they didn't do? You want to know what they didn't do?
I know.
With this re-release? They did not correct the Red Ranger's helmet. It still looks janky. Get this mess out of my face. Get this. Come on, y'all. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, I'm not trying to, like, dog Hasbro, because I understand. I get it. I understand that, you know, they can't be doing the things all the time. You know what I'm saying? Like, I understand that. But it's like, y'all already done, like, teased us with this little extra new episode of Dino Fury that we ain't heard nothing else from. Episode 13? Like, y'all teased us with that, with the whole Javi and Izzy little scene. And then we never heard anything from it. Now it's Power Month, and y'all are the only thing that y'all are giving us is some 90s flip heads and some toys that have already been released that obviously you have not fixed. Like, I mean, am I the only person who is like, what the hell? I don't know. Like,
That's fair to feel that way. Because you would expect them to be like going all out. Because the last announcements were pretty cool. And these ones were just like really lukewarm. So.
I mean, y'all went balls to the wall with them turtles. Like, I mean, y'all was just... shoving turtles all in our faces. And I'm just like, okay, we love it. But this, I'm just like, now come on, y'all. Now, if they would have given us the figures and then updated Jason's helmet to make it look like the metallic armor helmet, then I'd have been like, oh, yes. Oh, we love that. Thank you for correcting that. Thank you. Thank you. We love to see it. But this, I'm just like, babies, no, this ain't it. I would have been excited for the flip heads if that was the thing. If that was like the main thing that they led with and was like, this is what we're going to do for Power Month. This is like the next new thing. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. Mm-hmm. You know, instead of just kind of like dropping it on us and then running away. Kind of like how they did with Ninjor. They just randomly just threw Ninjor at us and was like, yeah, you like that? You like that? And then just ran away. Like, I don't know. Like, Lena girl, what you think? What, how you feel about it? I know you really don't give a damn about these toys, but I mean,
overall, I'm with you. Everything you've been saying, I'm just like, pretty much, like, that's exactly how I feel. Considering the fact that this is a power mod, this is the 28th year, like, I was expecting way more, like, that, you know, would be announced, right? To get right. Toys that we already got before, like, nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
We want new shit. Like, excite us. Like, heck, try to get people like myself who have not been excited for all the damn toys you've been releasing. Show me something. Tell me something. I want to spend my money.
I'm telling you. And I agree, Lena. I agree. I agree 100%. Because, like, the only time that I've, honest to God, have been very impressed and excited was with my sisters. With Aisha and Tanya. Like, those are the only ones that I was like, yes, Hasbro, I love it. Yes, right? Yes. And it's not because I'm Black. So I don't want you guys to get that, because I've been excited for a lot of the other figures too. But the thing that excited me the most is the fact that they understood the assignment with them. Because they could have really messed those girls up, like the way they messed up Ethan. They could have really did some damage.
Yeah.
But they didn't. They actually understood the assignment. And I mean, they got Nakia perfectly. Right. So, I mean, it's like they really understood the assignment and was like, we're going to try our best to get shit done correctly. So I'm like, if y'all can do this, then there is no excuse for any other toys. Do you feel me?
Exactly. Yeah. And that's just like, and then the fact that, you know, like for those of you who don't know, Nikita is Brennan's favorite Ultimate Ranger. So I love the fact that they got her dead on for you. And then for me, the one toy I was super excited about, because she was literally my hero, aside from Kimberly, she was my first Asian hero. I thought they were going to, you know, get her right on, because they got Trini right on.
They did.
Happy Chan. They fell so epically with her that I'm just like, I have no hope now. I just have no desire to look at their toys anymore, because I just feel like, Cassie, out of all people, you messed her up.
And Patty does not look like Miss Fairweather. I'm sorry.
She does not.
Like, Patricia does not look like Monica Lorenz. Like, she just don't. Like, she doesn't. Like, I'm sorry. I mean, don't get me wrong. Monica is a gorgeous woman. I mean, she was a Miss America, or was she just like a pageant girl? So she's a gorgeous woman, but that lady ain't Asian,
right? Exactly. So it's just sort of like, I don't know. It really got me feeling some sort of way where I was genuinely very excited, and I really was thinking, okay, this is gonna be one of my first figures that I will purchase. Because I think this is great. I can hold on to her. If I have kids, I can pass her along. And, you know, like, as an action figure. Like, look, here's an Asian superhero. Again, I get that we got Trini, but I'm going to say it. She's not that great of a character. For me?
I mean,
she's not.
I mean, you listen. Listen.
I didn't love her. Like, don't get me wrong, I love the actress, but I don't love Trini.
Yeah. Now, if we're talking about comic Trini, then I would be like, yes.
Right.
And I honestly wish, and to be truthfully honest, and this is no shade, and I want to make this very clear. I'm with Lena on this. It's not the we don't like tweet. So I need for people to separate the two. Exactly. Separate the two. It's not twee that we're talking about. We're talking about tranny.
Exactly.
That's who we're talking about. Because I do kind of feel like when you start going into talking about characters and this, that, and the third, there are some fans that just cannot separate the two for some strange reason. And I kind of may have an idea of where that reason is, but we're not going to go into that. But the point that I'm trying to make is that when what people need to realize is that when these people go home at night, they are the actor. They are their own personal selves, and they play these characters on TV. It is okay to love the characters that they play, but they are not the same. They are not the characters outside of the show.
Exactly.
So when Twee passed away, that does not mean that canonically Trini is dead. That does not mean that. It is the actress that passed away, not the character.
Exactly.
So if you don't like the character that was played, it does not mean that in any way, shape, or form you dislike her, the actress.
Exactly.
Does not mean that.
It does not
Exactly. So it's just like one of those situations where I do kind of feel like there are some fans that will literally just be up in arms and be like, how dare you say anything bad about her? And it's like, because I didn't like the character. I didn't say I didn't like her. I said I didn't like the character.
Exactly.
You know, so.
Absolutely.
At the end of, but like, I agree with you 100%. Like, to me, and don't get me wrong, I appreciated Trini for being who she was in the group. But overall, like, if they were to replace her with anybody else, I don't feel like the dynamic would have changed. High key, that is how I feel. Now, granted, you may say, no, because she was this and she was that. I hear you and I feel you. But at the end of the day, I'm sorry, but they were the same group, and Pilot Trini was a whole tomboy and she fit in just fine with that group.
Uh-huh.
So you could replace her with anybody and it would still have the same dynamic. Like, you would still have the same group. So me personally, I'm just like, I could take that version of Trini and leave her at any point. She was very interchangeable. Now, I know, Will, you're a Mighty Morphin person. do you feel like, you know, Trini bought anything special to the group? Like, do you feel like she bought something that is irreplaceable?
I mean, as far as that, I'm sorry. As far as
before you start, I also want to clarify, there is things that Twee brought to the character. Now, don't mistake Twee for Trini. I just want to throw that out there. But go on. I'm sorry. Don't do anything.
I just can't honestly imagine her not being with that group, and like, mm-hmm. I just can't imagine her not being there, honestly.
That's real.
As far as characterization, you know, she was the least developed, absolutely. Arguably, you could say that about, you could even say that about Jason. Jason had, he had a really strong presence, but he wasn't developed as well as he could have been.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't really much outside of being the team leader, which mm-hmm. is why I think, you know, sometimes when I hear people say that they like Rocky better, I think that's why. But I don't know. Like, I loved her. And it could be, you know, the nostalgia thing. It could mm-hmm. be because, you know, Twee's not here and that's all that we'll have of her as that character.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like that could be a part of it. But I just that whole group, the original six together. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm going to say that. It hit different.
Oh my God.
Like, as far, like, oh my God, the chemistry that they all had together. It just, and that's just like, it's just, that's my Power Rangers. I can't imagine anybody else there.
That's understandable. That is understandable. And I'm glad that you said something and you were honest with what you said. And that is something that I want to hit as a key point, but not to discourage or make you feel a way about it. But
yeah, I know exactly what you're going to say.
Yeah, you know where I'm going. It's the nostalgia. You know what I'm saying? It's that feeling of like, I can't see anybody else doing this because this is what I know. Like, this is like 100. Like, I can't, like, this is top tier. You can't get any better than this. I am 100% with you. I get it. I understand exactly where you're coming from. I guess for me, and maybe Lena might agree with me, but I guess in the vein of where I'm coming from, it's more so, I know this is what we're always going to get. And because that team was so dynamic and because they left such an impression that literally even Hasbro realizes, because Saban obviously knew, but even Hasbro realizes that with this fandom, they have to keep pushing these six on us. They have to. Because they can try to come out with any kind of brand new blah blah blah, gibbity app, new Power Rangers card Dino Zeo Crystal, like whatever. Like, they can try to come out with as many versions of Power Rangers as they can, but it will never top the Mighty Morphin Crew. And I'm not saying, I'm not saying that in a nice way. and it's literally because of the fact that we have cemented that original crew as untouchable, that they can't be touched, nothing can top them. And I feel like that is dangerous for a franchise, especially a growing franchise like this. And it should not be growing, even because it is 28 years old. It should not be growing anymore. By now, it should be so damn strong that, you know, like an anvil can't even knock that shit over. You know what I'm saying? Like, it should be that damn strong, but it's not. It's not, because literally it has half the lifespan of like a Star Wars. Like, it has half the lifespan of Star Wars. You know what I'm saying? And it's like Power Rangers is one of the longest living children TV franchises. Like, it's one of the longest and still going. So I'm like, no tea, no shade. We should not be here. We shouldn't be here in this spot. We should be so damn strong that literally, if we were to make any other incarnations of this group, of this show, we should not need the original six. We shouldn't need them.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
You know, and I feel like it's a dangerous game to keep on pimping out these same six, because no matter how you do it, I'm telling you now, the original actors and actresses, as we have proven with Twee, unfortunately, ain't gonna be around forever.
No, and you're absolutely right. Like, just exactly right where you're talking about that. Like, when people hear, "Oh, you're a Power Ranger fan," what is literally the first thing I always hear? "Oh yeah, I love Tommy. He was my favorite." Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like, it's always a reference back to Mighty Morphin. It's never. Mm-hmm. Like, the only ever time I get Neo Saban air is because I'm talking to a child, a literal child.
Yeah, a child or a Gen Z person.
Because
they were children around the time of like your Wild Force and all of that, right? And they kept it going.
Exactly. I have yet to meet them myself. But I've been running to a lot of kids at work because I keep wearing my Ranger stuff and I forget that I do, you know, because it's part of my everyday wardrobe. I really, really do. Like, I have this jacket with the pins that I bought from Power Morphicon a few years back, and I left them on there and never took it off. and I haven't watched
it. I think I know what jacket you're talking about, but go ahead.
Yes, exactly. That same one is still there. I haven't removed it. I never took it off.
Oh my God.
Yes, I never took it off. And
oh my God.
I think for the last 2 years, I actually forgot I had that jacket. So it's just been in the closet too, right? So as of recently, I've been wearing it a lot. And every time I wear it, I get people go, oh my God, is that Power Rangers? So again, either the older generation or the younger generation. If it's the older generation, it's a reference back to Mighty Morphin. If it's the younger generation, it depends, obviously, on which Power Ranger they got introduced to. But it's usually either Megaforce, Samurai, or Asif Light Dino Charge.
Yeah, yeah. No, like, and you're 100% correct. Like, it's one of those things where, you know, it, when people, and I've seen this comment a lot too, Lena, online, where people will go, you know, when they're talking about their favorite teams or favorite seasons, you know, they'll be like, oh, I grew up with Wild Force. Because that's one that really had a big impact on kids. Wild Force, for some reason, had a huge impact on a generation. I don't know what it is about that team.
Might be the aesthetic, the suits.
It could be that, yes. And the animals.
And what are their weapons? Those little the
crystal
daggers?
Sabers.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's something about that group of Rangers. And I think it's probably like you said, like Lena, the animals and stuff like that. It's that group that just really just stood out to a generation of kids, because there are adults now, young adults, who absolutely shit their pants when you start dogging Wild Force. Like, I mean, they get angry because it's like, don't talk. It's almost kind of like they're saying, don't talk about Mighty Morphin like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, they have that same love for Wild Force that a lot of people have love for Mighty Morphin. And it's like, I guess because it's more so when you start diving into those seasons like that, and you're giving like your opinions on them and things of that nature, a lot of these things will be biased because of the fact that these are like your first loves, like the closest things that you had or whatever. And it could be the first that, you know, you ever watched and just fell in love with it and was like, okay, this is the best. Like, there is nothing that can ever top this. Even though, you know, the show should be getting better, you know, or trying to improve on itself. But, you know, it just won't ever top that nostalgia in people's minds. I know for me personally, and I've always been this way. Sorry to y'all, Mighty Morphin, but Zeo for me, I was one of the ones who was trapped, who got hit with the Zeo bug. Because I promise you, that promotion for Zeo was probably the best promotion Saban has ever done. I don't care what anyone says. That was some of the best promotion I have ever seen. And it had me so hyped for Zeo that Zeo replaced Mighty Morphin for me. Like, it had me that hyped. Like, that hyped. Because it was like every week they had something new, like something ready, like, oh, the Zeo thing is coming, or oh, who is this person coming? And it's like, it's King Mondo or whatever. And then you always seen the different shapes being drawn. And I mean, they went all out for Zeo. And it's like, then when Zeo came, I loved the way the characters progressed, the way the situations just seemed like they got older with the characters, like a lot of characterization happened with the characters. Like, it's just so much happened. And that's why for me, Zeo just is always gonna be my all-time favorite season. Because it just felt like the show matured and it just got to this point of like, oh, okay.
It really did. It did hit differently too.
It felt different.
It really hit differently. And I think for me, it was the graduation scene where I was like, oh, they're adults. Right.
Like, yeah, like in Turbo, like when they graduated. Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, they're going into the world. Like, they're going to do things that adult people do. You know, obviously at the time we were still young. So, like,
right.
For us to think beyond the fact that they are going to be adults, they're going off to college, university, whatever. Sorry. You guys call it just college. We call it university and college, right? But,
yeah, we call it university too.
Oh, okay. I know, like, yeah. Some people are like, oh, just college. I'm like, oh, okay, cool, whatever.
I mean, we have just colleges, but we have university.
Okay. But yeah, like, and I just remember thinking, like, wow. And then, of course, the speech that Sordon gave really just, it just hit differently too. Just everything about it, the whole graduation scene, the whole, you know, we're going to move on, do other things. And then this had always stuck with me. Is when Zordon was all like, oh, it's time for them to move on to achieve greater things, yada, 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 and, you know, whatever. And I remember thinking, so you're telling me that their life is more valuable as an adult than it is as a child, as a teenager?
Listen, well, Zordon.
I thought that he was, because they had given quite a few years to the
mission. Yeah.
So it's like, okay, you guys have given, you've sacrificed a lot. It's time for you to see what else is out there. That's what I
took it like that. But then when I watched it again as an adult, or like as a young adult, I remember thinking, oh, I feel some sort of way. Like, I feel like that's the message here. I get it. I think if that was intentionally the message. But I guess when I dissected a little bit more, I just thought, wow. Like,
I almost kind of felt like they were throwing him. He was throwing him away in a way.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like, exactly. I used you for your teenage years. Now go and be great as humans, even though you're like completely screwed up in the head.
Exactly. No, that's exactly it, right? Because then he got a whole new team of young teenagers. So it's just sort of, so that's when it kind of hit me, like, because again, as a young adult, we watching it, I remember thinking, oh, so you replace them with a younger version, kind of like, I hate to say it, I know it's both and girls, but it's predominantly like, you know, guys. You always hear the guy go, oh, you're replacing me with a younger model of me or younger version of me or whatever, you know. And it's just sort of, I feel like that was the case, like, sort of replace them with a younger version of them.
Yeah. I mean, really, to be truthfully honest, like, well, Zordon and Demetria, but I mean, yeah, to be truthfully honest, like, I don't even hold you, that is what happened. Like, they kind of did replace them with younger people, and it's like, no tea, no shade. Like, I guess they wanted to try to use the whole high school aesthetic thing, like, you know, oh, they're in high school, so. But I never understood the idea of why you have to keep using high school people. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have to keep using teenagers.
I wish that they gave us an answer to that, because we never
We never did. So my only theory is that as a teenager, your schedule is much more flexible, and you're able to kind of get away with a lot more than as you would as an adult. That's my theory, right? Because, like, as an adult, I find myself, well, at least for my young adult years, I find myself caught up between college and working part-time, so I can make, obviously, some sort of making end meet kind of thing, and then in between scheduling projects and all that shit, right? Where like, maybe as a high schooler, I remember I had a lot more free time, and I was able to screw around. Like, when I mean screw around, I don't actually mean, like, other people, but I'm just saying, like, screw around, do a lot
of, God,
like, jack all, like, I don't know, like, I remember, okay, one of the big things I remember was, before I got to high school, I used to write a lot. I used to sit down, write, and read, and did all that. I got to high school, I didn't have time to write, but I had enough time to sort of squeeze in books, right? As I got to college, I stopped writing, and I stopped reading altogether. So I just find that as life progressed, you have less and less in your schedule. So my theory is that maybe as a teenager, you have a much more flexibility than you do as an adult.
You're easily moldable.
That too. That sounds like they're grooming them. That sounds wrong.
Yeah. It is very it's very much grooming, absolutely. And I mean, like, I mean, that's kind of what it's kind of what happened. I mean, Zordon really was like a father figure to them. So, you know, it was very much like, it was very much grooming. It really was. It really was. But yeah, like, and I agree. I agree with you. It's just like, my thing is, I feel kind of, I really do feel bad for the Turbo Crew, because the new teens and the new teens, they got so much flack by fans. And I'm just like, now I understand y'all was mad because the veterans left. Well, they didn't leave, they got fired. But like, you know, yes, I know we were upset. Hell, I was even upset. I ain't gonna even hold you. I was mad. But we can't also forget the fact that these are completely brand new people, and they were thrown into this war against a malevolent space pirate who already wanted revenge on the previous group for killing her husband. And now she has this thing of wanting to take over the world. And it's like, you threw these new people in here with hardly no training. So they're going off of, you know, the best they could do. And they held their own. So I'm like, y'all have to be able to hold space for them, because like, I felt like personally, even with the veteran Rangers, I still feel like they would have got caught with their pants down. I still think they would have. I don't think they would have been able to defeat Gold Goyle without getting rid of all the Zords. Hell, I don't think Tommy was smart enough to do what TJ did with throwing the Turbo Realm into Gold Goyle's mouth. I don't think Tommy would have ever done that. Tommy's not smart enough to do that. Like, let's be frank. He's not smart enough to do anything like that. he's not smart enough to do that. I mean, legit, like, Tommy is all about sacrificing Zords. Like, yes, TJ did that too. But other than that, that's the extent of Tommy's wit. That is the furthest we gonna go. Like, sacrifice the Zords, throw them away. Hell, we seen that in Dino Thunder, and he a whole ass 40 some odd year old man, and he's still talking about sacrificing Zords, and that is his end all be all. So at the end of the day, Tommy doesn't have the strategic skills that TJ has, and the quick thinking on the feet that TJ has. So I feel like TJ definitely deserves his flowers as the leader of that team. And I think that honestly, it would have went way worse if Tommy had tried to lead that group with Gold Goyle. But that's a whole nother story. But speaking of finales and episodes, child, that is all that pretty much the fans wanted to see with our power.
That is pretty much all.
We're getting DMs on like, what about the endings? What about the endings? And I'm just like, yeah, but not all the endings were great.
Right. Not even that. I don't even hold you, Lena. Like, it's not even that just all the endings are great. It's like, and this is no shade to the fans that want to see this. Like, it's cool. My thing is, y'all are asking for team ups and endings and finales, but it's like there are so many good episodes that are leading up to this stuff that is like, oh wow, this is really good. Like, there are a lot of good episodes, like In Space.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are a crap ton of wonderful, wonderful episodes in Space. Like, I put up, I almost put up all the episodes of the Psycho Rangers. Hell, Countdown to Destruction is probably one of the best finales of all time. And yes, I included the finale because I'm like, that's one of the best finales ever. Like, there were so many great episodes in this space, and the ones y'all chose was always a chance. No Tino Shea. And once again, I'm not trying to be funny, but I'm sorry, that episode was one of my least favorite episodes.
What? In
space. It was.
Wow.
And not because, and to be, I'm not even gonna hold you. I was so happy to see Adam back. Like, Adam literally made the episode. Literally, he made the entire episode.
Yeah, I was like, that was a good idea.
That, like, and trust me, I'm with you. I'm with you on that. Like, it's a flawless idea to bring back an old ranger to help with the new ranger. I'm with you. But what I'm not with is this whole rigmarole with Carlos always wanting to goddamn quit. I'm like, when I tell you, even as a kid, I was like, I am sick of this guy. Like, every 5 minutes, he wants to quit. And this is one of those episodes. Dude, you accidentally hit Cassie. It was an accident. She's not mad at you. You still, I'm going to quit because I might hurt somebody. And you don't.
Yeah. I have a question. What if Carl's, like, behavior is actually more of a narcissist situation?
What do you mean?
He wants the attention on him.
Like, it's very, I personally feel like he does this for attention. Yes, right. I am with you.
Behavior, you know, like the whole petty, the whole like manipulation. Like, I feel like
feel bad for me.
Yeah, I feel like all of this is like an actual situation. Like, he's not like, I'm trying to be the good guy. I'm trying to do what's right by the group. I'm trying to do what's right by Earth. Was right by Zordon or whoever's in charge. You know, like, I feel like this is just more of a personal narcissistic behavior.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Lena, I'm with you. I'm with you because I genuinely feel like that you would not be far off if that was the case. You wouldn't be far off. Because when I tell you, they all signed up knowing that this is what it is. When you sign up to be a ranger, you sign up knowing that, hell, you might get killed.
Yeah.
You might get hurt.
Yeah.
So if you hurt somebody by accident, it's an accident. Hell, exactly. Cassie even, like, tried to beat in your head when they were in the little semi-deck room thing, hospital room, whatever, and she playing with Alpha. She literally was trying to beat in his head, dude, it's an accident. Like, it's okay.
And he's right.
I'm sorry I hurt you. Oh my God. Like, come on, man. Come on. Get your life together.
Yo, I have another question. It just dawned on me. Where is the military in this Power Rangers world?
Girl, where they always are, non-existent.
We saw them in Terrible, right?
Were they military? I mean, they might have been National Guards.
Passing the torch.
Yeah, that was probably like the National Guard or something. Right. Being like, you know, all right, everybody move to safety. Because, you know, apparently in Angel Grove during this time, they had shelters for when for when monsters would attack. They would go to places, even sounding alarms like, all right, guys, a monster's here. Get to safety. You know, I'm like, if I was living in Angel Grove, bitch, I'd have been moved out so damn fast. Because I'm like, what's not about to happen is I'm about to get crushed by a building. Falling because y'all wanting to battle giant monsters and shit. I know, right? You lying.
I'm surprised the city is full of people because first of all, where's the military? Like, usually the military is always involved in giant things like that or alien invasions. Like, where are you guys? Secondly, why is a group of teenagers trying to defend the world? Like, I'm not that I'm against it because, hello, we are Power Ranger fans, but it just dawned on me only because you said, you know, you signed up for this. You know you're about to get hurt. It's kind of like, you know, when people sign up for the military, they know that there's a great chance they're not coming back. And if they are,
exactly.
you know, if they are coming back, they know there's a great chance that they're going to deal with post-traumatic stress, post-traumatic anything, right? So
exactly.
Yeah. So that's what it dawned on me. Like, where the frick is the military? Where are all these people? Where's the big firearm? Where's the, I don't know, the Navy SEAL? Where's the Air Force? Where are all these people?
Maybe they're using their brains because they know that they could get squashed.
Or, right, maybe they were just like, we know we can't handle it, so we're going to let the Power Rangers handle it, kind of thing. Like,
yeah, we'll let 5 teenagers handle it. We're grown adults.
Well, shoot, they don't know. They don't know that they're teenagers.
I mean, this is true. They don't know. But I'm just saying. Literally.
They just think they're aliens. It's like, let these aliens handle it. Let these aliens fight them. It's okay.
Right? 5 suits handle them. Okay, cool.
Okay, like, let them do it. Like, and I mean, to be truthfully honest, like, if I was over the military, and like the president or something, I would do that. I'd be like, okay, we got these 5 coordinated aliens with big robots, and they gonna take them down? Let them. Like, I'll use our people just to kind of, you know, move everybody to safety, and that's about it. But other than that, this is out of my pay grade. Like, no.
I mean,
Let them go.
No, I'm surprised they didn't try to take... The president, whoever, didn't try to take credit for it. Like, I only say this because I watched a movie recently. I think it's called The Tomorrow War or whatever. I'm sure you probably guys seen it. It's a new movie that just came out with Chris Pratt. And long story short, because it's not Power Rangers related, people from the future came back to the past to essentially warn the people in the past about these alien invasions of these creatures-looking things. There are spiders that are essentially going to take over Earth. The people in the past told the president, and because they needed help, and the president was all like, well, the president's all like, well, I'm not going to send help. Like, how do you know for sure? You have no proof. Because I think the people at the Chris Pratt character end up coming up where the layer would be. And so essentially they're in the past, and they figure out that if we stop them now, we can stop them in the future, kind of a thing. Although it took a whole movie for them to realize that is what I've been saying from the beginning, but whatever. So long story short, the president took credit for the fact that Chris Pratt's character ended up stopping the alien invasion from happening in the future.
Of course he would.
So I was surprised.
Of course he would.
That the president,
not surprising.
Right? In Angel Grove, is not trying to take credit either.
Yeah, like, I mean, in this world, I'm pretty sure the president is like, yeah, we're over the whole Power Rangers group. You know what I'm saying? So we would totally take credit for everything. It's totally fine. You know, listen, I think they would because of the simple fact that it's just like, this is out of their realm. Like, this is out of the ordinary for them. They can't handle this. And I mean, hell, we even seen it in Time Force when the Silver Guardians tried to create, what is it, Raimi? That little, that tank or whatever that tried to take down one of Frax's robots. And clearly, that thing just kicked that little tank to the next part of the city. So it's like, they can't fight these things. So it's like, it's almost a mute point to even try to even fight them, period.
Like, to be fair, Rensic people was kind of like aggressive. Like, they were like, Rensic was very hands-on, okay? Compared to like Rita and Lord Zedd, where they're hiding in their moon somewhere, where I feel like Rensic was very like, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna like do what I need to do to you. So I feel like he was very hands-on. So I could totally see why the people in Time Force didn't win so much against it, like, you know, with the military crew. Where I feel like Lord Zedd and Rita, you know, they're hiding. They were sending the weakest monsters constantly. So I feel like there was a greater chance that they could have done that. Where, you know, Rensic was all like, victory's mine, so I'll take it with my own bare hands. Yeah.
And it didn't help that Rensic also made it personal. Which, right? I kind of feel like that was the driving force behind him. And that to me made him way more dangerous.
Exactly.
Than Aretha or Zedd.
Exactly.
And that's why for me, I'm sorry, I just don't, and I think I said this last week, I don't think Rita and Zedd are dangerous. No, I really don't.
I agree with you.
I never thought of them as dangerous villains.
Me too. I genuinely never thought of them as dangerous either. I always thought they were just, I, in the beginning, used to think they were comic relievers.
Zed was scary.
Yeah, that was it.
But, yeah, that's like, about it.
But then after he got married to Rita, he wasn't so scary anymore.
Not at all.
So, I don't know. So, yeah. So, with that being said, I see your point, but I feel like Ransick was a greater villain than...
Absolutely.
Or, you know, so...
Yes.
I think that's why they didn't win. The military there didn't win because, you know, they just didn't know who they were facing. But...
Yeah.
In Asia, it's a whole new different story.
Right. And I mean, like, and even then, it's like, going back to Carlos, it's just like I said before, Carlos knew. Like, he knew what he signed up for. So it's like, my guy, I'm pretty sure when they was running down these handbooks or whatever training that they had to become Rangers, I'm pretty sure Demetria made it plain. Y'all might get hurt. So if you want to do this, I'm just letting you know now, you might get hurt. You know what I'm saying? So I just don't understand why every 5 minutes, this guy just consistently just always was like, oh my God, I hurt somebody, or oh my God, woe is me. Like, it's just, come on, man. Grow a pair.
He belonged on the Overdrive team.
Oh my God, yes. Carlos definitely belonged on Overdrive. Absolutely.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. I am. Yes. Yes, Will. You are exactly right. He did. He belonged with Overdrive. Because them hoes would quit in a heartbeat. You talking about somebody that didn't give a shit? Fuck the world. Listen, them hoes was like, man, this shit getting too hard, man. Nah, fuck this. I'm out.
I can't.
Listen, they were some of the most realest Rangers I have ever seen in my life. them hoes was real. They was like, yeah, no, I'm sorry. Like, it's a dub. It's a dub for me. No. Mm-mm. Y'all out here looking for these damn jewels. Y'all, you got me in the hot ass desert. I'm fighting fear cats and shit. They kicking my ass. Listen, I'm tired. I'm done. Like, it was nothing for them hoes to give up. So I'm with you. Like, put Carlos on that team because he would have fared well. Like, he would have been great with them.
He would have been fantastic. Oh, my God. Oh, all it took was him being like, I think we need to quit because we hurt somebody. All right, I'm out.
Right? Yep, you're right. You shouldn't have hit her with your bow staff, man. You shouldn't hit her. Yeah, I think we need to quit, bro.
Oh my God.
They would have just upped and left.
Right. To be fair, though, to that particular team, they were not chosen. They were picked. I don't know how. I don't know why. I don't know what skill level they possess, but they were picked.
I mean, well, they did have specific things that they were picked for. They did. They had specifics. Like... Will was like a spy, which, you know, could be used with his techniques and stuff, could be used in, you know, stealing jewels and stuff. So it makes sense. Ronnie was a race car driver, getaway girl, you know, getaway car driver. We need her. Dax was agile, you know, with him being a stuntman. So if you needed somebody to, you know, defend and be agile, it's him. And Rose was the smart girl.
For somebody who's agile, he was very clumsy.
Well, also, too, like, that jumping power was just dumb. So, I mean, damn, I don't know why they gave him that.
I don't even remember them having civilian powers. Damn.
Yeah. Like, and then the Black Ranger had the worst of them all. Man. Talking about super sight and super hearing. If you don't get the fuck out of my face with that shit.
Oh, my God.
If I was Will and you gave me super hearing and super sight, I promise you I'd be like, put me back in this damn machine and give me some real powers, because you're not giving me this. Rose over here being the smart girl and she can turn invisible, but yet I'm the one with the special shit and you give me goddamn super sight and hearing. Fuck out of here. But that's a conversation for another day. But the one But you know, that's the one that the people chose. The people chose, you know, that foolishness. So I was like, fine. But they did do it right when they chose to the 10th power. Because this right here is one of my favorite episodes. I was like, y'all did good, fans. You did good. Because when they chose to the 10th power with my people, the Lost Galaxy versus in space, I was like, this is cute. We had fun. We like it. First of all, we all know what's going to happen, obviously, with what happened on the subsequent episode, the follow-up episode. We know what happens. Kendrick passes. Mm-hmm. Now, to be truthfully honest, when we did the vote for this one, a lot of people, and I don't know if people, just felt like they were going to be both episodes in one, like we were going to do both. I don't know if people thought that or not, but I did them separately. And this episode was higher than Kendrick's death episode, Power of Pink. Mm-hmm. So why do y'all think that is?
That was actually a really good point. I didn't think of that.
Because I feel like that was a lot more monumental than to the 10th power, which don't get me wrong, I love to the 10th power. That is one of my favorite episodes. Yeah. But I felt like for me as a Power Ranger fan, I was like, I personally thought in my heart of hearts, I personally thought that Power of Pink was going to beat this. I legit thought it was going to beat it.
I mean, you already kind of know the answer to this. It's the team up situation.
But that's the thing. Like, Power of Pink still had the space team there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's still a team up, technically.
This is true.
So I mean, that was my thing. That's why I'm like, I just legit feel like I don't know whether the fans thought that we were going to do both of them at the same time or what. I don't know, but it's just weird to me because I'm like, this is much more of a stronger episode than to the 10th power.
And I agree with you. The only other thing I could possibly think of is maybe they just didn't recognize the title and they recognized it.
I was thinking that too.
When I was reading through the, because I vote myself too, right? Just for fun.
Me too.
Some episodes I don't even recognize. I'm like, I don't recognize these names. So the ones I don't recognize, I just kind of vote down. The ones I do recognize, I'm like, oh, okay, I'll vote out for that because I recognize it, right? So my they probably just recognize the 10th power because, like, the name is very obvious. So that's why they just probably didn't recognize it. So I think if you had specified or posted a photo that was very obvious, maybe.
I did post up, you know, Kendrick's in the vortex before she did the final slash. Right. Like, I did post that. So I'm just, like I said, I understand exactly your point because there are some votes that I really do feel like that's exactly what it is. Fans just didn't recognize it. Mm-hmm. But I've made sure with that one, I made sure specifically, I was like, I want to see if they're gonna pick this one. Because like to me, like I said, I just felt like Power of Pink was the stronger episode of the two. Because it was so emotionally driven. Like so emotional.
It was. Another thing I could possibly maybe point out is sometimes in stories, you don't always see the whole thing. So maybe they just read the title, they saw the thumbs up or the thumbs down, and then they immediately just responded without actually taking in the photos behind it. Because sometimes the photos behind it don't, either it doesn't make sense to them or they don't recognize it, or they didn't have time to actually take it in. That's another possibility. Because I know sometimes when I do stories too, I focus on the caption first, if there is any, and then I focus on the photos after, right? So especially it's one of those situations where you actually have to be interactive. It could be, I know it's going to make it sound so silly. It's so dumb. but it could be just too much for us to handle. So it's like, I read the title, I click yes or no.
That's real. That's real. Yeah. No, and that's
I'm thinking like the visual of the 11 Rangers with a Magna Defender and the explosion that was it for a lot of people. And then to see the, even though Kendrick's moment was like huge, I just feel like maybe just seeing that image of the team up was just like, oh my God, that's so epic, you know, because it like that was like number two, right? Power Pink.
Yes, that was the second one. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so like at least we know that there were a lot of people that did actually remember that one was. It wasn't a somber, you know. That could be another reason.
Yeah, and I mean, like I said, it just hit different. We're seeing that a lot this episode, but it did. Like to me, it did hit different. Like that episode was just, I don't know. It was just something about that episode that was just like the hype. Like I'll never forget. After that episode happening, literally sitting in front of the TV, my mouth agape, and then me running to my mom, screaming, saying they killed the Pink Ranger. Like, that is literally the only thing that I could talk about for like a whole day, was just they killed the Pink Ranger, they killed the Pink Ranger. Like, I could not get that out of my head. So for me, as a nostalgic moment, or something that I just can't forget, you know, that is like top tier. Like to me, when I think of Power Rangers, that is one of the things that I think of, is that specific episode. Like, so for me, I'm just like, no shade to the 10th Power. I love that episode. But if I was going to pick an episode that was like, oh yeah, this is what I want, it would have been to the Power of the Pink. Like that would have been it for me. But like I said, to the 10th Power was a great episode. And it, you know, it did showcase everybody, and you know, it did its thing, which I loved. Like I loved all the interactions, especially how, you know, the new team members came in, you know what I'm saying, standing all proud, chest out, titties perky, you know what I'm saying, like ready, you know what I'm saying. So, you know, I'm with it. Like, I loved it. But for me, I'm just like, all right, whatever. Whatever, you know. Whatever.
Hi.
But yeah, so that was that one. Now for Lightspeed, I kind of knew Fate of Lightspeed was going to be it. I knew that. That was a given. I was like, they're going to choose Fate of Lightspeed. They're going to choose that one.
What was by Lightspeed again?
The finale.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah, like I knew they were going to choose that one. Like that was obvious. And to be truthfully honest with you, like when they picked it, I already had began creating the post for it. Like that's how I knew. I was like, they're going to choose Fate of Lightspeed. They're going to choose Fate of Lightspeed. I already know. You know, so, and they did. That's what happened. 98% of them did too. You know, so that's almost everybody. Fate of Lightspeed, the only thing that really got under my skin, I won't say got under my skin, but the only thing that kind of made me feel some kind of way was the part where Miss Fairweather was like, you know, I'll go out on that date with you finally. Girl, we are in the middle of a pod that glass is about to break and we about to drown. Girl, if you don't get out of my face.
Wow.
Girl, if you don't get out of my face. Like, and Joe had the best reaction to that. He was like, stop playing with me. Like, stop playing right now.
Do you think that she thought that they were going to die and she was just saying it?
No. You know what? No.
I think I think she always had a crush on him.
Me too. And, me too.
Really?
I think
always.
Always.
Not always. Not, I wouldn't say always. I wouldn't say always. I think
point,
she wore him down.
Right.
I think he wore her down.
Exactly.
He wore her down.
I think at some point she was like, yeah, now this guy's kind of cute. He likes me.
Right.
You know?
He likes me.
But, you
I
know,
guess.
I guess. Like, no one else is really looking at me right now.
Wow.
So, I'm just saying. Let's be real here, okay? That's exactly how my thought process would be. And that has actually happened to me. That's a true story. That's actually how my first ex-boyfriend many years ago got me. He wore me down. I was like, you know what? No one. It's not like I have a lineup of suitors, so.
Oh, my God.
Like, facts, I'm just saying.
Oh, my God.
No, she's like, he ain't so bad. Like, he's got the bod, and he's a ranger, and he cares for people, and, like, you know, it checks all her criteria, so why not?
I can't. I mean, yes. I'm with you on that one. Like, for me, it's just kind of like, I do think that he wore her down. And then finally, you know, she was like, okay, yeah, let's do it. And he's like, girl, if you don't get out of my face, you're about to die. You're about to drown. No. And she's like, no, I'm serious. And that's when it was like, oh.
And okay. I think that, yeah, no. And I think because at that point too, he was just like, I don't believe you because you expect that from me, you know, kind of thing. You expect me to hit on you. So when she finally said, yeah, he was just like, wait, no. Now he's playing with me. Now he's getting my hopes up for no reason. And you're just playing
with me.
But it turned out that she really was not. She was really for reals, giving it a shot.
And I mean, my thing too, and I'm not even gonna hold you, like, dead ass, like, it didn't blow up in their faces. You know what I'm saying? And that's how I knew that it was real. Because it definitely, and this is what I'm, and the thing that comes to mind is Anya and what's the baby name? Oh boy. Xander from Buffy. When Xander, it was about to be the end of the world. And Xander was like, Anya, will you marry me?
Oh no.
And it was like, he did that because it was like, oh my God, it's the end of the world. You know, I'm dating this girl, but she's the last person that I'm ever going to be with. So, you know, I guess I got to accomplish something in my life. So I guess I'll get married.
Damn.
I mean,
Xander is trash because let's not forget, Xander stood that girl up on the altar over some bullshit. I'm sorry. God, like, he did it over some bullshit. And I'm like, that was the reason. That was the moment when I said, and I'm gonna get back on Power Rangers, I promise. But that was the moment when I said, fuck Xander. Xander is the worst character ever in the history of Buffy.
There were moments before that.
I mean, yes, there were definitely moments before that. But that moment right there, when he pulled that stunt, I said, forever fuck Xander. Forever fuck Xander. Like, you are not ever gonna get any sympathy from me.
Yeah, it was Anya was an ex vengeance demon, her old boss, basically, to get back at her for wanting to be human, he created this fantasy and shows Xander his future married to Anya, where they were miserable and he became abusive just like his own father. And then that scared him off from wanting to marry Anya.
Wow.
But they found out that it was all a trick and he still stood her up.
Right. Right.
Wow.
Right. Exactly.
That was heartbreaking.
That is why I was like, go ahead.
If that is the case, he does not, you're sorry. I lost a trail of thought, but I agree with you. No.
Like, I was like, forever fuck Xander. Like, that right there was like, nah. Like, that is the epitome of, like, fuck you. Like, no. And then, like, what made it so maddening is the fact that his friends let that shit slide. They were not on Anya's side, and they left Anya out to the dust. Like, they just left her.
Wow.
They were all like, oh, well, you know, Xander feels bad. And it's like, fuck Xander. Like, you literally just, this man literally just left her standing at the altar.
Humiliated her.
Humiliated her. And, yeah. And you're sitting here like, well, he feels bad too. Fuck his feelings. I'm sorry.
I mean,
but
in
no.
In all fairness, get you some friends that's that loyal, okay? Like, get you some friends. I mean,
now, Lena, I'm with you on that one. Because, I mean, they were loyal to Xander in the end. I mean, they were just like, well, you have to see it from Xander's point of view. And I'm like,
I mean, I don't.
Are y'all serious?
I don't agree with what he did, but get you friends that are that loyal, okay? Just saying.
Okay. But getting back on Power Rangers, this is why I say that I feel like Miss Fairweather minute. Because yeah. We ain't got nothing about Miss Fairweather and Joel broke up or got a divorce. So apparently, based on the canon, they still together. So she really did mean it that, you know, she loved him.
Aww.
So it was like, okay, cool. But I'm like Joel, though, in that moment, I'm like, don't play with me right now. Like, I don't need this. And she was just like, no, like, for real. So, like, that was sweet. But at the same time, I'm like,
wrong time.
That is the wrong time.
Yeah, wrong.
That's the wrong time for that.
Maybe that's what was needed to encourage him to do whatever he needed to do.
Well, we saw in that scene where they were in the submarine, and he was like, I got a date to get to. And Captain Mitchell is like, we're still sitting in the air. Like, we can't move. So, I mean, oh boy, like, I'm sorry. I thought that scene was funny. But oh boy was just like.
That was cute.
I got a date. So yeah, that did give him the boost he needed.
Yeah.
But yeah, like overall though, I mean, and this is no shade of Lightspeed, but Lightspeed just didn't have, it didn't really have any moments to me that made me go, this is going to be hard. Like, which one am I going to like choose? You know what I'm saying? Like, Lightspeed really didn't have anything for me other than the Ryan stuff. Like, after the Ryan stuff, that was it.
Yeah.
That was it for me. I was like, oh, okay, Ryan. Okay, what else? And like, I was literally going through it all, and I'm like,
The team up, I'm surprised that didn't. How did that do?
The team up, I believe, was like 89, 90, something like that. Mm-hmm. Like, it wasn't like top like the rest of them were. Which I thought that I thought it was going to do well, but no. Because I thought, like, because with Trakina being back, I thought people were going to be like, oh, yeah, like, you know, this is the one where Trakina returns. But nope, it didn't go well. So I was like, okay.
I think what it is, too, is, like, I think at that point people were over her.
Could have been. I mean.
Came back looking like a roach. Ew. Because I was over her. I was like, really? Like, and I'm speaking from, like, young me watching that, not, like, me now. I haven't watched Lightspeed Rescue in a really long time, but young me was thinking, really? You're back?
I mean, listen, I'm not even going to hold you. Like, I was a little upset because she came back in her humanoid form.
That confused me.
And I'm like, exactly. I'm like, why, if y'all could not get Amy Miller back, if you could not get her back, then why not just bring her back in her roach form? Why bring her back in her humanoid form? Like,
that's
that did not
point.
Make sense
that's a good
to
point.
Me. Like, that
yeah,
that
wouldn't
just
you think that,
sense.
Yeah, you think that she'd still be that, that slimy green thing.
Exactly. You think she'd still be the bug, but she wasn't. So it's like, okay, all right. I guess I'll believe this. And then, you know, she becomes a big bug again at the very end. You know, so because basically all she's doing is sitting down the entire time. She doesn't fight at all. Like, she's literally sitting in a chair. So it's like, the Trakina we knew was a hard-hitting fighting badass. Yeah, especially after Villamax trained her. I mean, she was kicking ass and taking names. So I'm like, how did she go from that to now sitting in a chair and looking like she on life support? Like,
she was blown up, so I guess she was still weak.
I mean, that's the excuse. I'm pretty sure that's the excuse they had because they were using the life force of the people to give her power. So, I mean, I that's probably was the excuse for it. But to me, I'm just like, y'all couldn't had her get up at any point to try to fight them? Like, at any point? Like, at any point? Maybe? No? Oh, okay. Like, all right, fine. But yeah, I mean, that team up to me, it was one of the weaker ones, in my opinion. It was weak for me. But yeah, so it didn't get chosen. But like I said, I knew Fate of Lightspeed probably would have, and it did. And then End of Time. Now, End of Time, y'all. End of Time. I ain't gonna even hold y'all. End of Time. That thing broke my heart.
Yeah.
It was one of those finales that just... There was so much that happened. And it was told very well. It was told very well. Which I kind of knew the fans would vote for End of Time as well. Because it was a very good finale. It was very good. But like I said, they had other moments. Because I'm sorry, a lot of the stuff with Eric, mwah, amazing. Eric was just such a rich character. God, Eric was such a good character. And Dan Southward acted his face off. Ah, the beats, honey, the beats. Aaron Cahill showed up for the assignment, but so did Dan Southward, okay? Mm-hmm. Because when I was going back through some of them episodes, I was sitting there looking at Dan Southward like, you did your homework. He said, oh, I finally got on this show now. I finally got a role. Yes, I am going to act down. I am going to act the house down. Because when I tell you that man showed up to the assignment, like, he showed up. Like, he definitely contributed to the class project. He definitely did. So yes, anything for him, I think would be great. Would have been great. The one that I really thought was going to be high, and it was like 86%, like 85-86%, and I was hurt. Movie Madness. I just knew the fans were going to pick Movie Madness.
I thought so too.
Ever remember watching Movie Madness?
What? Oh my God. Movie Madness had some of the best scenes ever. First of all, you had Jen looking like a damn, like, Chun-Li. You know what I'm saying? Like, whooping stuntmen's asses. Then you got Katie dancing with the black dude with the soft shoes. Like, I'm just like, yo!
when everybody gender bended.
Okay. You got the men in... Oh! I loved it. Wes had ass. Now, Wes had a fatty. Wes had a fatty dress, bro. I'm sitting here like, damn, Wes got cake. Okay. That dress was fitting in all the right places. I said, I know that's right.
Well, you better. You definitely have to watch that at some point, Lena.
Yeah.
I don't know how.
Right.
You got to watch that one.
Because I was like, I don't ever recall it. I keep seeing the references back to it, but I don't remember it, you know?
So it's just
I've seen it.
One I thought that was going to be, well, in contention for winning was the episode, I forgot the name of it. It was the episode where we found out that Alex was still alive.
Ah, yes. That was actually one of the ones that I picked. Oh shoot, I know what episode you're talking about. crap, but I don't remember the name, but I know which one you're talking about. Because that's the same one that, yeah, it's the same one where the episode after Alex took over and then he told Wes that his dad was going to die. Mm. And he was going to take over the company, which I think Alex had something to do with. I think Alex came back and he took back the power and he made it to where Wes's dad was going to die. So because he knew that Wes was going to go back to his dad first. I feel like Alex had something to do with it because Alex saved his life. Alex saved his life in that hospital room. So I think Alex gave whatever that man had to put whatever he did to put him in the hospital. Oh yeah, Rancic shot him. That's right. Rancic shot him because he was going to steal. You are morbid. But Rancic shot him and he went jumping backwards and slid into the wall. that mug went sliding into the water. I was like, oh Lord, he done killed Wes' daddy, Lord Jesus.
I was like, that shocked me the first time I saw that, for sure.
No, that shocked me too. Because like you don't see that. You never see civilians get shot on this show. Like that's something you just don't see. But Rancic told him to move. Like Rancic was like, get out of my way. You know what I'm saying? Or you know, you're gonna get these hands. And he's talking about some, you know, I was so hard on my son before, and I let him down, but I'm not gonna let him down again. And I'm like, bro, what you gonna do? What you gonna do, man? Like, you ain't got no power. What you gonna do? And Rancic shot his ass. And I'm just like, now you sliding into the wall. Like, that's what you get. Like, you know, but I'm with you. Like, I thought that one, because I did choose that one. I thought that one was going to get picked. It didn't. Anything with Eric, it was low. Actually, the Eric stuff was very low, to be honest, which surprised me. I was like, why is the Eric stuff so low? Like, the Quantum, his first episode, that episode was really low. So I'm just like, this is interesting to me. But yeah, all those episodes weren't that high. And like I said, Movie Madness was like 89. It was like something like that. Or it was like in the mid to high 80s. Like it was like 85, 86, or 89. It was like around that, but it wasn't a 90 at all. And then, you know, of course, End of Time was, you know, the big cheese. End of Time was if I'm not mistaken, let me see. Let me double check because I don't want to lie to the people. End of Time was 97%. So, you know, everybody was going to go for End of Time, which I knew. But I just figured that everybody was going to, you know, everybody was going to at least, you know, go for some of the other episodes. But no. And I mean, like our friend Violet Rangers, she even was like, why not Movie Madness? Like, there's so many good episodes. And I'm just like, yeah, I know. I agree. There's a lot of good episodes in this show. You know, like regular episodes, but fans don't want to see them. Like, you know, they're like, they want to see finales or team-ups. Like, that's what it's going to be. But yeah, other than, you know what? Now come to think of it, you talking about Wes's daddy, Eric got shot too, remember?
I actually don't remember that one.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it was in the finale. I think it was the part two to the finale. He ended up getting shot because Wes and his daddy was embracing, and that Crybot had got up and was like, and had pulled out his weapon and was aiming it at him, like, yeah, I got you now, bitch. And Eric saw it and jumped in the way and shot him. But at the same time, the Crybot shot him too. Mm. And little known fact, Eric was actually supposed to die.
Oh.
Yep.
He was supposed to die. I know his counterpart died and when he jumped off a bridge or something.
Yeah, he jumped off the... well, no, he didn't jump. He got shot. and he fell off the roof. Well, off the balcony. He fell off the balcony. But yeah, like he was killed. But originally in the original end of time script, they were going to kill off Eric too. But they decided to change it because they were like, they didn't want to, you know, traumatize the children. They didn't want to traumatize them because this time, you know, if he would have died, like he wouldn't have had a Kendrick's come the Jesus moment. He just would have been dead. So, you know, ain't no bringing him back because this is a finale. So you kill him, he's gone. But nah, they decided to not kill him and just made him severely injured. So that's the reason why he gave Wes his quantum morpher. And, you know, that was that. Please, we are doing Power Month on our page, where literally all you have to do to participate is just click the thumbs up if you want us to post it, and the thumbs down if you don't. And yeah, like, we definitely like to see the ones that you guys pick, because, you know, it's a gamble for me, because I be like, I wonder which ones they gonna pick. I mean, sometimes I know it, and sometimes I'm very surprised. So surprise me, guys. but yes, but this has been another episode of Tribute of the Grid. My name is Brandon.
I am Lena.
And I'm Will.
And we will see you next time. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.